Good morning, students. Myself, Mrs. Jaya Jadhon. I will teach you science. Or in science today, we will learn or we will continue our first chapter. In the previous lecture, we have completed few topics, that is health, diseases, types of diseases, spreads of communicable diseases, and prevention of communicable diseases. Now, in this topic, we will cover the topics, that is vaccination, non-communicable diseases or non-infectious diseases, and nutritional deficiency diseases, diseases caused due to overnutrition and some wrong food habits. So, let's begin. The first topic is vaccination. Some communicable diseases like polio, tetanus, tuberculosis, etc. are very serious and can prove fatal. These diseases can be prevented by vaccination. Vaccination. Few communicable diseases are very serious and they cause death, like polio, tuberculosis, tetanus. To prevent these diseases, vaccination is done. What is vaccination? Or we can say that vaccination prevent us from these dangerous or serious diseases. Vaccination is a process of injecting vaccines into the body for protection against a disease. Vaccination is a substance. Vaccine is a substance which contains dead or weakened germs. What is vaccination? Vaccination is a process through which vaccine can be injected into the body of a person to prevent or to prevent from diseases. Now, vaccine is a substance which contains dead or weakened germs. It helps body to develop immunity against diseases. What? It helps body to develop immunity against diseases. Vaccination is given between the age of 0 to 10 years. However, some diseases like hepatitis A and chickenpox, vaccination can be given at any age. Now, in this vaccination, we have learned three terms, that is vaccination, vaccine, and immunity. Vaccination is a process through which vaccine can be injected into the body of a healthy person. Vaccine. What is vaccine? Vaccine is a substance which contains dead or weakened germs, through which the body get immunity or body get develop an ability to fight against the related disease. Through vaccine, what is the vaccine? Vaccine is a substance which contains dead or weakened germs. The vaccine get entered through vaccination and it gives the strength to the body to fight against diseases. Now, immunity. Through this vaccination, body get immunized or immunity power gets developed. So, what is immunity? Immunity is the ability of the body to fight and kill the germs. Immunity is the ability of the body through which germs can be killed. In body, through vaccination, the immunity develops in the body and through which the germs can be killed. Now, there this is a table through which we can learn some vaccines and which are given at which age and the full forms of these vaccines. So our first vaccine is BCG and OPV. BCG means Bacillus Calmette-Guerin, and OPV means oral polio vaccine, which is given at the birth, which is given at the birth. Now next vaccine is DPT and OPV. The full form of DPT is diphtheria pertussis and tetanus, and OPV, as I explained you, oral polio vaccine, which is given at the age of 6 weeks when the baby is 1.5 months old. At that time this vaccine is given. The next vaccine is DPT and OPV. It is again given at the age of 10 weeks. It is given at the age of 10 weeks. Then next is DPT and OPV, which is given at the age of 14 weeks. That means when a baby is 3.5 months old, at that time this vaccine is given. Now next vaccine is measles vaccine. It is given at the age of 9 months. When it is given at the age of 9 months. Next vaccine is DPT and OPV booster dose of polio and MMR, which is given at the age of 18 months. When a baby is 1.5 years old, at that time this vaccine is given. Now next vaccine is DT vaccine, which is given at the age of 5 years, which is given at the age of 5 years. And the last vaccine, that is tetanus toxoid, that is given at the age of 10 to 16 years. Let's revise the full forms of these vaccines. BCG, the full form of BCG is Bacillus Calmette-Guerin. DPT, diphtheria pertussis and tetanus. OPV means oral polio vaccine. DT means diphtheria and tetanus. MMR, that is measles, mumps and rubella. These are the full forms, and these are the vaccines which are given at different age. Now next is non-communicable diseases. As we have learned about the communicable diseases, the second type or the second type is non-communicable diseases, which are also known as non-infectious diseases. These are those diseases which do not spread from one person to another. Non-communicable diseases are the diseases which are not spread from one person to another. They may be caused by deficiency or overnutrition. These diseases are not caused by germs. A non-communicable disease can be caused when a body part do not function properly. Diseases caused by unhealthy lifestyles are heart diseases and blood pressure. Now, as we know that non-communicable diseases are caused, or there are three reasons of causing non-communicable diseases. The first is when there is a deficiency of a particular nutrient in our body, then deficiency disease caused, or then nutritional deficiency disease caused. When there is a excess intake, or when we take some nutrients in excess amount, then overnutritional disease caused. So the first reason is that when there is a deficiency of nutrients, then non-communicable disease is caused. When there is a overnutrition, or when we take or there is a excess of amount, when we intake excess amount of nutrients in our diet, then also non-communicable diseases caused. And the third reason is unhealthy lifestyle. Due to unhealthy lifestyles, non-communicable diseases are caused. For examples, heart diseases, blood pressure, etc. So, what we have learned in this, non-communicable diseases? Non-communicable diseases are those diseases which do not spread from one person to another. These diseases are not spread through germs. These diseases are not spread through germs. As we have learned in communicable diseases are spread through germs or microorganisms. But non-communicable diseases are not spread through germs. There are mainly three reasons due to which communicable diseases are caused. The first reason is if there is a deficiency of nutrients in our body, then communicable disease caused, and that is known as nutritional deficiency disease. If there is an excess amount of nutrients in our body, then also communicable disease caused, and that is known as overnutritional disease. And when our lifestyle is unhealthy, then also communicable disease caused, and these diseases are heart diseases, blood pressure, etc. In communicable disease, our body part does not function properly. In communicable diseases, our body part of our body does not function properly. So, next, nutritional deficiency disease. First, I will explain you what is nutritional deficiency disease. Nutritional deficiency disease caused due to deficiency or lack of a particular nutrients in our body. This happens when we do not eat a balanced diet. When there is a deficiency or lack of nutrients in our body, then nutritional deficiency disease is caused. Diseases caused due to overnutrition. Excess or overeating of a particular nutrients may also cause a disease. When we take excess amount of nutrients in our diet, then it causes overnutritional diseases. Then it causes diseases which is known as overnutritional diseases. For example, obesity or fatness is a result of overeating of carbohydrates and fats. For example, obesity, which is caused due to overeating of carbohydrates or fats. The excess of carbohydrates get converted into fats. Storage of fat makes us obese. Such diseases can be cured by eating balanced diet. Correcting wrong eating habits and exercising regularly. So, these diseases are caused due to excess intake of carbohydrates and fats. As we know that carbohydrates store in our body in the form of fats. And when there is a part of fat is utilized by our body, but if it gets stored in excess of amount, it causes obesity or sometimes it causes blood pressure and heart diseases also. These diseases can be cured by eating or by taking balanced diet. These diseases are cured by taking balanced diet. We should improve our food habits also. We should follow some good food habits also to avoid these diseases. Now, nutrients related deficiency diseases are. Here I will explain you some nutrients and their deficiency disease. So our first nutrient is vitamin A. Due to deficiency of vitamin A, the disease which is caused is night blindness. Which disease caused due to deficiency of vitamin A? Night blindness. And what are the symptoms of night blindness? Dry eyes, improper vision in dim light, ulcers in eyes. A person is not able to see in dim light. In proper light, he is able to see, but in dim light, he is not able to see, and our eyes become dry, and there is an ulcer in eyes. Next, vitamin B complex. If there is a deficiency of vitamin B complex, then which type of disease is caused? Beriberi. The disease which caused due to deficiency of vitamin B complex is beriberi. Now, the symptoms of beriberi is loss of appetite, nervousness. These are the symptoms of beriberi. Our next nutrient is vitamin C. Due to deficiency of vitamin C, the disease caused is scurvy. Scurvy is the disease which is caused due to deficiency of vitamin C. The symptoms are swollen and bleeding gums. The gums get swollen and there is a bleeding. Second, frequent colds and pain in limbs. There is a pain in limbs. These are the symptoms of scurvy disease, and which is caused due to deficiency of vitamin C. Our next vitamin is vitamin D. Vitamin D is also known as sunshine vitamin. What it is also known as? Sunshine vitamin. Because vitamin D synthesizes in our body in the presence in early sunlight. If we take early sunlight, so in our body vitamin D get synthesized. So due to deficiency of vitamin D, the disease which is caused is known as rickets. Got it? Rickets caused due to the deficiency of vitamin D. What are the symptoms of rickets? Soft and weak bones, deformed bones. These are the symptoms of rickets. Vitamin K. Deficiency disease which is caused due to deficiency of vitamin K is hemorrhage. What is the disease? Hemorrhage, which is caused due to deficiency of vitamin K. And what are the symptoms? Slow clotting of blood. Vitamin K actually helps in clotting. And if there is a deficiency of vitamin K, the blood will not get clot, and it slowly, the process is slow of getting blood clot, or blood get clot slowly. Now, next is calcium. Our next nutrient is calcium. Due to deficiency of calcium, the disease which is caused, the deficiency disease caused, and the symptoms are weak bones and teeth. Weak bones and teeth. Iodine deficiency disease. Due to deficiency of iodine, a disease which is caused is known as goiter. Goiter is caused due to deficiency of iodine. What are the symptoms of these diseases? Enlargement of neck region. The neck region get enlarged. This is the symptom of goiter disease. Now, iron. Due to deficiency of iron, anemia causes. Iron is a nutrient, mineral, and due to deficiency of iron, anemia, the disease which is caused is known as anemia. What are the symptoms of anemia? Face and nails look pale. The face and nails look pale loss of weight. There is a loss of weight. Now, as we have seen that few nutrients, there are some nutrients, the deficiency of these nutrients causes different diseases. Now, let's come on our next topic, that is wrong food habits. Some people may take too much of common salt in their diet. Eating too much salt can lead to high blood pressure. As we take too much salt in our diet, it causes blood pressure. Some people are in habit of taking too much salt in their diet, and which causes blood pressure disease. Got it? Now, next is excessive intake of fat soluble vitamins A, D, E and K in the form of pills can lead to hypervitaminosis. There are two types of vitamins: fat soluble vitamins and water soluble vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins are A, D, E and K. Water soluble vitamins are B and C. If a person take more vitamins, more this fat soluble vitamins in their diet in the form of pills, it causes a disease which is known as hypervitaminosis. If a person takes too much fat soluble vitamins in their diet or in the form of pills, so which disease is it cause? Excessive intake of fat soluble vitamin causes hypervitaminosis. Excessive consumption of fried and fatty food causes obesity. If we take excessive amount of fatty substances or fatty foods and oily foods in our diet, then it causes obesity. So here we have completed our chapter, and let's revise the chapter which we have covered. What the name of the chapter? Health and disease. In that we have learned about the health, disease, types of diseases, spread, means of spreads of communicable diseases, and vaccination, non-communicable, non-infectious diseases, nutritional deficiency diseases, diseases caused due to overnutrition, and some wrong food habits. Thank you.